In this video, we are going to go through using your Techkon SpectroDens for G7 for offset. The SpectroDens has G7 functionality with target references and tolerances built right into the device. This makes it ideal when doing press tests to help and assist the press operator in making quick adjustments to hopefully hit your desired color target. To start, select the G7 function, then go to G7 Setup. I'm going to use single spot mode, although you can select various control strips for scanning. Then choose your paper type and target color reference. I'm choosing CRPC6. All the required neutral print density values, aim points, and tolerances are loaded, as you can see here. SCCA, that's substrate corrected colorimetric aim points, are also available if you want to use that function. Once you're finished, use the red button to go back to the main screen, and you're all set to go and start with white paper measurement. The first thing we need to do is to measure the solid primaries, CMYK, to see what adjustments are needed to get these in tolerance. You can see here we've got high delta E's for the cyan and magenta, and the yellow and black can probably be improved as well. But the nice thing is with the SpectroDens, with one click, it tells me and gives me all the information that I need. We've got a high delta E's, you can see there, 7.74, and that's because we're running way too much ink. Density is 1.73 for the cyan. But if I reduce that by 0.47, in other words, bring it back by 26.4%, I can achieve a low delta E intolerance of 2.1. From here, whilst the press is running, we need to carefully communicate with the press operator the press adjustments required to get the primaries in the first instance in tolerance. This may mean start-stop of the press and or a few goes to achieve our ideal result.
Once we have achieved the lowest delta E's for the solid primaries and we have checked the other important metrics such as overprints, etc., we are then ready to measure the P2P chart to create our G7 calibration curves. We recommend you measure three press sheets, two P2P targets on each. You can measure directly into curve 4, and here the six measurements are automatically averaged. This is from our first run, the linear run. The green line is the desired NPDC, neutral print density curve. The red line is the actual press result. The print result here is too heavy. Grey balance on the bottom left window shows the print result is too red, way too warm. Next, go to the ink and substrate tab. Check to make sure the delta E of the ink and the paper correlate to what you are reading on press. On the G7 tab, the report shows a failure to meet the delta L and delta CH requirements. That's tonality and grey balance. But this is not unusual for the first run, which is linear. On the G7 master tab, the results are shown as compared to G7 compliance levels. This is an easy way to see how a G7 master submission would be judged. Finally, we can create our curves. The screen above shows the curve values to be entered into the RIP for G7 creation. Curve 4 allows you to export curve data in almost all RIP formats. With the curves input into the RIP, we output our second set of plates for our calibrated print run. Make sure you carefully measure and check the plates to ensure the curves have been applied correctly. Back on press, run up to the exact same densities as recorded from the first linear print run. Check the primary solids CMYK and overprints to make sure they still meet the requirements of our reference print condition. If the sheet is even for colour, in register, and there's no defects, we can begin to evaluate the grey balance and neutral print density. If all is okay, we can then pull three sheets, for example, to measure, check, and confirm our results. Now, if the grey balance is little out or little off by 1 or minus 1 for the A and B, for example, we can then make small density adjustments to move the grey balance slightly closer to where we need to be. You'll need to check the solids and the overprints. Be careful here, because you don't want them to move out of tolerance. But these small adjustments should be able to give us the grey balance that we're looking for and we need. If we cannot achieve the adjustment with the slight moves that we're trying to make, we're going to have to stop the press and iterate our current plate curve using Curve 4. With two measurements of the P2P chart in Curve 4, we can immediately see the NPDC curves are now almost right on target. If we go to Analyze and the G7 tab, we see that both our NPDC and grey balance are within tolerance. At this point, we've achieved our G7 calibration. Finally, on the G7 master report, we can see the measurements have passed the G7 targeted compliance level. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video. It is really only an outline, and it is best if you attend a G7 expert course to gain complete insight on all the details. With your improved skills and knowledge, you too can become a G7 expert. For more information about the next G7 expert course in your area, please go to our website, idealliance.org.au, or drop us an email.